Ubiquiti have just launched their first switch in their new Pro Max line that includes RGB.
Yes,
RGB. These four models all include Etherlighting, which is a feature that helps illuminate ports to help you identify devices, VLANs, and even link speed. The first switch in this lineup is the UniFi Pro Max 24-port PoE. It has 16 gigabit Ethernet ports, 8 of which are PoE Plus on the far left, and another 8 of which are PoE Plus in the middle. And then you have 8 2.5 gigabit ports that are PoE Plus on the far right. They are even marked as such on the faceplate. Then to the right of that, we have two 10 gig SFP Plus ports. And the switch can deliver 400 watts over PoE to power things like access points, cameras, and even other switches. Pretty typical, right? If we compare it to their other Pro offering, the Pro 24 PoE switch, which is not the Max, you can see that with the Pro Max, they've upgraded 8 of those ports to 2.5 gigabit with PoE++. Another thing that I noticed when comparing it to their existing Pro switches is that they've decided to center all of their ports. If we look at their existing Pro switches, they are all right aligned, which doesn't change the functionality, but does introduce some wiring challenges, as I found out on my own Pro 24 PoE switch. It seems like Ubiquiti might be having second thoughts on that design, as we can see that their enterprise switches had the ports centered. And now they have done the same on the Pro Max lineup. This is a good move. Tell me you've done front-end development without telling me you've done front-end development. Now, I know that's purely cosmetic, but this is a cosmetic device. Or is it? Where this switch sets itself apart from other switches out there, and even their own lineup, is the new RGB lit Ethernet ports called Etherlighting. All 24 ports on the Pro Max switch have individually addressable RGB lights that can be controlled within the switch's settings. When booting up the switch, you can see the range of colors as well as the loading sequence they have programmed. Pretty awesome. Once the device has booted, the lights will begin to glow with this really nice breathing animation, kind of pulsing. The default Etherlighting settings color codes each port according to their connected link speed. As you can see in this configuration, I have my 100 megabit connections yellow, my gigabit connections pink, and the 10 gigabit connected devices green. This can be adjusted to any color you like, or you can set them to the defaults of yellow, blue, and white. Now, this is nice, but I think color coding them to their network or VLAN is more helpful. When choosing the setting, each port will glow according to the VLAN that it's assigned to. Now, this is super helpful when moving ports around, as you may not want to plug it into the wrong VLAN. I have some more ideas on how this could be more helpful, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. Another way that you can use this is to help you locate devices and ports on your switch. If you want to locate a specific port, you could open the port manager, select the port, and then click locate. This will dim all of the ports and flash each of the ports you are trying to locate. Another thing you can do is locate a Ubiquiti device and the port that it's connected to. For example, if you want to locate this access point along with the port it's connected to, I can go into the device's settings and click on locate, and the device will flash and the corresponding port will flash too. It's pretty cool stuff. I wish that this would also work for all client devices and not just Ubiquiti devices. Maybe in the future? Another item that launched that you can see in the fine print of the product page is UniFi Etherlighting patch cables. These are super thin, slim patch cables that help increase the lighting effect on the Pro Max switches. But does it work, and are they any good? Yes and yes. I've been a huge fan of slim patch cables for my rack and even bought some with a translucent boot to do exactly this, but those are no comparison to these patch cables, and let me tell you why. First, these patch cables have a premium feel to them. Yeah, it's kind of weird talking about the feel of a patch cable, but they have this smooth feel and are very soft and bendy. They aren't stiff, so you'll get the perfect loop when patching this to a panel. Next, they don't have any markings or labels on them. They're unmarked and a pure cool white. The boot on them is a little shorter and stubbier than other cables, which I'm not sure if that's a pro or a con, but then the boot itself is almost like frosted glass. It's not really glass, you know, it just looks like it. This helps them give off a nice diffuse glow when they light up. Comparing them to my other cables, you can see the difference in quality and construction right away. The other thing that I noticed is that these cables have really good quality control on them because they are all exactly the same length. You can see that my other cables have a huge variance in length and quality and in the cable jacket. And while most won't even care or notice, it really throws off my loop when patching things in. I feel like I'm starting to become a patch cable aficionado. Is that a thing?
It is now.
So what are my other thoughts about this device? Well, I mentioned a few things throughout the video, but I'll try to summarize them here. First, the big question. Is it worth it? Well, when you compare this Switch to their other Pro offering, for $100 more, you're upgrading 8 ports to PoE++ and 8 ports to 2.5 gigabit. Then, you're getting a redesigned layout with all 24 ports across the front of the Switch. Then on top of that, you're getting RGB lighting on each port. Now, even if you're not into RGB, I think that the $100 to upgrade this Switch might be worth it if you're looking for the upgraded PoE++ ports that are 2.5 gigabit, especially if you only need a few for your AP backhauls. So, are the cables worth it? Well, I think the cables are going to be up to your own personal preference. If you like a more diffused light coming from your Switch port with a more consistent quality to help you get the perfect loop, then this cable's for you. If that doesn't appeal to you, then there's no reason to swap out your existing cables. It would be awesome though if they could find a way to get a small piece of fiber in the cable jacket to have the cable itself light up. Okay, maybe I'm going too far. Now there were a few things I would love to see improved with the Pro Max Switches. The good news is that it's all software, so it could come in the future. First, I'd love to see the option to light up the RGB on the port when the devices aren't connected, especially when it's in the network or VLAN view. This would help you from plugging in the wrong device to the wrong VLAN, which is something I typically do on my desktop Switch. Should add that to desktop Switches too. Next, and maybe this is obvious, but let me assign the color to any port and not based on anything other than my own preference. If I want them all pink, let me go pink. If I want them to match my color scheme I have in my room, let me do that. Or if I want to make my uplinks one color, just because I don't ever want to unplug my uplinks, let me do that too. Another thing I would love to see is a different animation for the lights. It seems like the breathing or the pulsing is the only option. And since we don't have any traditional activity lights, I think that an animation might be nice to have to flash on activity. Another thing I would love to see is a way to turn them off altogether. I've noticed that you can turn them down to 1%, but 0% or off could be nice in certain situations. Now, I'm fond of blinking lights, but others might not be. And this is also a huge step to having a Switch that doesn't waste any power on lights when 99% of the time no one is there to see them. A lights out mode or a timer that turns them off after the LCD screensaver turns on would be a nice touch. So whether you're an RGB enthusiast like me who thinks that there can be utility in RGB if done the right way, or you think it's useless, you have to give Ubiquiti some credit for taking a risk like this and creating a line of switches that have RGB. Ubiquiti have been improving their virtual port manager as well as their AR port manager, and I feel like this is the next step to a physical port manager, embedding more information into their switches, ultimately helping you out, or at least giving you something pretty to look at while you're working on them. Well, I learned a lot about the Pro Max switches, RGB lighting, and I hope you learned something too. And remember, if you found anything in this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.